by a tour guide.
I mean, I think certainly think it's fun. There's a, most of the expats are on the Hong Kong side, but I think there's a really cool scene in the Kowloon side, and that's mostly locals, and it's under the tunnel. So when that thing that he did when you're trying to grab a taxi that's going on the other side, like that's a real thing. It's like, are you going under the tunnel?
Yeah, well, watching this movie hopefully gave you some idea of what to do. So basically, everything we show in this movie is like the best places to go. The Hong Kong Tourism Board should be paying us.
I want people to go to that gin bar. I think nobody knows about it.
That it's called Ping Pong 129, and it's the coolest gin bar.
It
is because you went there. But when we shot in that bar, it's only been open for like a month. Like we were the first film to shoot at that bar, and then since then the bar owner's like, oh yeah, like we're getting calls all the time, like people wanting to shoot at our bar.
I think that's a great homage to your film as well.
Yeah.
Yes, the gentleman over there. How was the film funded?
Well, the film was all funded independently, so it's pretty much all self-financed.
Next question. Yes, see the young lady. Okay.
I'm actually from Hong Kong, so it was really cool seeing the scenes. Like, we're both born and raised there, actually.
Oh.
So to see it, and I think you did a really good job. But this question is for the two lead actors. So, I don't know if it actually goes into the sequel that you want to do, but.
Can you speak a teeny bit louder or something?
I think I left. I did not go upstairs. No.
We invite you upstairs.
Yeah, it doesn't turn into like a horror film. Kicked out the door. It got real weird.
I think we got time for a couple more questions. The young lady over there?
I will tell
you. He's here!
No! He has not seen the movie, and he keeps emailing my producer asking to see this movie. I'm like, you cannot show me this movie. Yes, I have seen him again, and we've actually become friends, but I will tell you this. I think the movie is a lot more romantic than the actual. It was like very anticlimactic. He's like, oh, I have a girlfriend, and I have no intention of leaving her. I'm like, oh, okay. That was like not a lot of sexual tension.
Are they still together?
No, they're not still together. But, you know, I have a different boyfriend now, so.
Okay. Really beautiful.
We actually shot on the Canon C500. We shot on two cameras, and we actually got the camera from Film Independent. So they gave us the entire camera package for free, so Canon and Film Independent, which really helped us out. And we didn't even have to settle for the camera just because they gave it to us for free. We actually did a camera test in Hong Kong where that was the camera we wanted to use because it was very lightweight and because it was, you know, running and gunning. And we did all of the post-production in Los Angeles, so we didn't do it in Hong Kong.
Thank you. I think we got, yes, all the way to the back, Frank.
I want to ask about the Richard Ng scene. Like, how did it come about? Like, how did you reach out to him and ask, hey, can you be our fortune teller?
So Richard is the fortune teller in the movie, and for those of you who don't know, he's actually a really famous veteran actor in Hong Kong. And originally, when I wrote the scene, I thought I was just gonna hire some real fortune teller from the fortune teller row, and my producer's like, no, you can't do that because they're not gonna know how to act. So my producer actually knows Richard's daughter, so that was the connection. And she's like, you need to meet Richard. He's a brilliant comedic actor, and he's, you know, my friend's dad. Like, just meet with him. And I met with Richard, and literally we spent 3 hours talking about his character. And like, he was on set for less than that amount of time, but he's just such a dedicated actor. Like, he like brought on all these like backstory of the fortune teller, and he came really, really prepared. And then once we were on set, I would say like half of that scene was improvised by Richard and the actors, and they just really went along with the ride.
It was great. Can we talk about, before we close the session, can we talk about your next project? Is there something already happening? For actually, I'm going to ask to all three of you, your next project, can you already talk about your next project?
This is, in the last month, I've had like 4 films come out. So, this is one that is the most personal to me, and I'm very happy with this one. Last month, had a small part in the HBO film called Bessie, and in music, but on an album, and now I'm in development on a couple projects at the moment right now.
What about you, Jenny?
Same.
Okay. Great. I really love Eden, by the way.
Thank
I wanted
you.
To show it. Someone
else
did. Yeah, that's great. What about you?
Yeah, so I have a couple scripts in development that I'm attached to direct, and there's one that once I'm done with this, probably ready to kind of go out to casting and financing, but with, independent films, it's sort of like, unless you find cast and money, it might never happen. But also, just based on the buzz of this film, I've got quite a few people that want to, set up meetings and needs when I get back to LA, so we'll see if any opportunities kind of arise from those.
Well, we certainly hope to see more of your films and all of you. So, thank you guys.
Thank you guys for coming out and supporting. We really appreciate it.